He's been asked to go to the video monitor. Any drama this could be.
That's 100% a yellow card.
Can you argue that's a red?
Yeah. Shabilko with the move. Was this a foul on Herbert?
Oh, it's Instant Replay presented by Cheez-It Time. It's Andrew Wiebe, Charlie Davies, and the same two words always apply, Chuck.
Let's go.
All right, we start at Rio Tinto Stadium. Second half stoppage time. It's 1-1 Real Salt Lake. The home side are pushing for a goal. Here comes the cross. On the end of it, the Karate Kid, Demir Krylock, and Tim Parker's defending, and Krylock's going down, and he's saying, hey, Nima Sagafi, that should be a penalty kick. Sagafi goes to the monitor, Chuck, after Kevin Terry Jr. The VAR says, you might have missed something here, but he sticks with his call on the field, which is no PK. What do you think?
To be honest, I was a little surprised because when it goes to VAR, you can clearly see that Tim Parker has Demir Krylock's arm. He's pulling Krylock down, not allowing him to get up and rise for the header. In that instance, I think he's going to call penalty. But on the flip side, I've been in that position a million times, and defenders get caught with their hands in the cookie jar and never get called a penalty on. So it's kind of what I expected.
C'est la vie, huh, Chuck?
C'est la vie.
Now it's probably not a time for us to roll that reel of Charlie diving in the penalty area, right, producer Rich? Right? Oh, okay, no, I agree with you, man. This is a PK. I think it's a PK because Tim Parker's not playing the ball. All defenders do this, and they're definitely going to do this in second half stoppage time. But he's grabbing, he's pulling Demir Krylock, he's preventing the header that could be the go-ahead goal. That's intentional. That's a foul. That's a PK, in my opinion. Oh, to Cascadia we go. Lucas Cavallini was a busy boy, Charlie. We start with his 21st-minute tackle on Christian Roldan. Roldan beats him. He's to the end line. He's going to cross. No, he's pulling it back. And oh, God. Train wreck. Scissors. Yellow card, says Guido Gonzalez. Rami Tushan is the VAR here. They don't go to the monitor, but, man, that looks like it could be red, Charlie. What do you think?
I think they got this one right. This was not a malicious tackle. Cavallini is going for the ball. He's trying to block the cross. Yes, it's reckless. The trail leg comes in and catches Roldan late, but it's not done with excessive force or brutality. Therefore, it can't be sanctioned as a serious foul play.
Oh, I don't know about that, Charlie. I'm reading the laws right here, and it's not an and, it's an or. So I'm just going to read the law. Using excessive force is when a player exceeds the necessary use of force, so excessive force, you're saying it's not there, and slash or, that means or, endangers the safety of an opponent. I think it endangers the safety of Christian Roldan in this case. I would have been okay with a red card, but as it stands, watch Roldan dap up Cavallini after the play. He is not infuriated, as he might be if he thought his safety was endangered, so ultimately, I'll be with you on this one. I'm okay with just a yellow card. How about this? Do we agree in the 56th minute? Lucas Cavallini scores this goal. It's a big one in a draw between these two teams. But watch. Just look. Oh, did he gather that with his arm, Charlie? Is that a handball? On the field, it was called as a goal. There was no review.
Yeah. That one's going to have to come back. As you can see, slowly and ever so slightly, the ball does careem off his forearm. He uses his arm to keep the ball just in front of him so he can score the goal. And this is a letter of the law, my friends. After the ball has touched either their hand or arm, even if accidental, immediately scoring in the opponent's goal, it is ruled a handball.
Boy, I argued with Charlie till I was blue in the face before we did this taping, but I guess I am learning. I didn't see it as clear and obvious, and that might be why they didn't go to the monitor on this one. It is ever so slight, this touch of the arm, but if you watch it closely, I see the spin of the ball change as it comes down, and that to me says that it hit his arm, and in using his arm to control and scoring, it should be a handball, in my opinion. All right, to Chicago, Philly we go for a wild one and into 3-3. First play up in the docket, 16th minute. Sergio Santos is getting in and he's scoring. He's celebrating, but no. AR Jeremy Cuso says, that was offside, and let's rewind and figure out why. So here's the initial ball in behind, the play into Corey Burke. At this point, I think Sergio Santos is clearly onside. He's even with the final defender. It's after the ball gets to Burke that there's a problem here. The first touch is on the fire defender. You can see it outside of the boot, but there's Corey Burke getting a touch and putting it off the knee of the defender, which Sergio Santos cleans up. That is Burke playing the ball, and when he does so, Sergio Santos is in an offside position. Great call in the moment by Jeremy Chiesa. That's offside in my opinion. Well done. But how about this one, Charlie? Here's a goal, an own goal. There were a couple of those in this game. In the 79th minute, Kasper Schabilko gets a lot of space after this challenge with Fabian Erbers. Did he foul Erbers? We got a lot of people on Twitter saying he did.
Yes, this is a clear foul for me. Kasper Schaboelke comes in with his forearm to the back of former Union player Fabian Herbers. It is a foul. You can't come from the back and use your forearm to shove the player to the ground to gain an advantage into the final third. Unfortunately for Herbers, they didn't rule it a foul.
I don't know if it is clear and obvious. All the angles I saw are pretty hard to see the contact, but I see the contact just like you do. I actually saw Schaboelke's right knee contacting Herbers' extended left foot, and that's what I think took him down. Either way, we agree. I think this was a foul. Last but not least, we go to LAFC Sporting KC in Kansas City. I was there, and Charlie, you're done. We're not going to agree another time. We both are on the same side here. Tristan Blackman, sent off, straight red from Chris Pinto. Was this dog so, or should it have been a second yellow? Either way, the result stays the same. Blackman would be off. I think that this is dog so. Here's why. You have to consider the distance between the offense and the goal. It's just outside the penalty area. Shallowy is entering the box. The general direction of the play, he's going to goal. The likelihood of keeping or gaining control of the ball, Daniel Shallowy is going to get a shot off. And the location and number of defenders. There are two, but they're not getting there. Best case scenario, it's a sliding last second block. To me, that's an obvious goal-scoring opportunity, and it is the correct call. Red card. Well done to the crew in Kansas City, and well done to all of you for hitting us up with all the plays you want us to check out over the weekend. On Twitter, there you are, bottom of the screen, Charlie and Andrew, do it every single weekend. We'll see you next time.